Hello and welcome back. Today we are going to talk about Android custom build template for Godot. Okay, so here I'm using Godot 3.6. So how do we use the custom template? Okay, so I had followed this documentation and these two, but yeah, it's pretty clear how to generate templates, that's and all. But here are these details how to use the templates. Okay, but this didn't generate me the expected result. Okay, always when I use this template, the generated output are always the same, nothing different. Okay, then while going through the process, I found a way that generate something somehow optimized file for me. Okay, so this may not be the best approach or the approach that it to be followed, but it does work for me, so just I'm here to share the details. Okay, so what I just did is I simply generate run this command to build the Godot. So it generate these two files. Okay, so once we create these two files, we can run this command to generate the templates. Okay, so as in the documentation, I started using these two templates, but it didn't generate the expected result. So while attempting myself, what I did was first I took these three files and replaced it on the template folder first. Then what I did is I entirely removed the Android directory from where I'm currently building. I removed this one. Actually, what I did that I rename it to something else so that if anything went back, I can simply start using it. I simply rename it to 3.6 or something. So after that, what I can do is I can go to the project and install Android build template. Okay, so now what it does it, since we have already replaced these three files, it will use this file to generate new template. So this Android will be a lot smaller than these two files. Maybe it will have the output from different stuff, I mean. So now when I generate the apk, it give me a different apk. Okay, so it's the file are reduced. The abb file that I used to upload in the Play Store is about 4 MB, smaller than the previous one, and the app is already being released, and the app is around 1 MB less than previous one. So yeah, it did the work. It did work. Now I figure out, at least I know the way. There are maybe other options to further optimize the site, but now it works. Okay, so yeah, simply going through what I simply did is downloaded the 3.6 stable code, then run that scan command. It will generate these two files and the build on this bin directory. After that, we run the gradle command from platform Android from here, and that will generate these additional file. Then there is this template directory. So from this template directory, I simply replace these three files. After that, I remove the Android directory and install it again. Okay, so now when I build, it does the job. Yeah, that's it. This may not be the best way, but it worked for me. So that's, I just want to share this. Hopefully, some of our few hours of your time will be preserved. Okay.